believe the grail actually exists.
The search for the cup of Christ is the search for the divine in all of us.
What did you find, Dad?
Me. Illumination.
It's all about illumination. Becoming immortal, becoming a god. Paul warned us, you cannot drink of the cup of Christ and the cup of devils. Can't do it. Here is the cup of Christ. But you can't have, reach over here with my left hand, you can't have both. You can't mix the two. You cannot mix God's power and magic together. Somebody sent me this, and I'll tell you what, this broadcast comes out as a result of people with eyes all over the world that are watching what's going on, and they send it to me. Pastor Mike, I need to take a look at this. I've told you about the Message Bible. The New Age Bible, or the New Age Bible, that is out there, and it's just loaded with New Age symbolism. I mean, it just stinks of it, is what it does. It is so far removed from the pure words of God. It's absolutely insane the number of pastors that are actually using the Message Bible in their worship services, in their literature, in everything that they got it up on the screen. Nobody's carrying a Bible. Let me tell you what the Message Bible says. It is absolute. The Message Bible is right out of the pits of hell, and it's being used to indoctrinate our churches. So now, it's a marketing thing, but not more than just marketing. It's a way to get people to fall. Here we have a devotional book called Solo. It is based upon the words of the Message. It's a remix of the Message Bible, and it's laid out in a sort of a like a daily devotional form. But here's the real danger behind this thing here. This is from Amazon.com. This is just a clip out of it. The devotional you hold is unique. It's designed to teach you to study the Bible, but rather to develop a conversation between you and God. And I want to stop right here. Neil Donald Walsh came out with a book several years ago called Conversations with God. Now, he was not reading the Bible. He went into a trance, and God began to speak to him while he was in this trance. And he wrote Conversations with God because he thought he was talking to God. He really was, and he was talking to a familiar spirit. Here they are again, the familiar spirits guiding people into the new world order. And he wrote in this Conversations with God certain things like, God told me, you know, the Bible, man has made way too much of that. I'm not confined. I'm not confined to this little book. I'm much bigger than that. I say things that are not in the Bible. That's a setup. That's a setup. So they want you to have a conversation with God. How do they want you to do that? Lectio Divina is more Bible basking than Bible study, as it teaches you to absorb and meditate on Scripture, to converse with God openly, and to live out what has become a part of you in His Word. Lectio Divina. Sacred reading. Contemplative prayer. Lectio Divina has everything to do with taking just a portion of Scripture. Let's say Mystery Babylon the Great, the Mother of Harlots, Abominations of the Earth. Let's say Mystery Babylon. I can take a portion of Scripture. I can close my eyes, go into a dark room, light a candle, put on some really weird monk music in the background, and I can empty all my thoughts out, and I can go, Mother of Harlots, Mother of Harlots, Mother... And I can bring myself into a trance, into a hypnotic state. And when I get there, I'm going to have a conversation with a God. It's going to tell me. It's going to enlighten me. It's going to bring me illumination. It's going to bring me the God that is on the inside of me. That's what Lecto... So here this devotional guide, full of a false New Age Bible, telling church people. See, Lectio Divina comes right out of the Roman Catholic monasteries. Why? Because their agenda, you know what their agenda is? The agenda of the Roman Catholic Church is to restore all of who they call the separated brethren, that is all the Protestants, all the Baptists, everybody, back into receiving the Eucharist. Are you with me? You follow me? Because that's where it's going. And so that's what Lectio Divina is all about. It's about chanting to go into a trance, to receive the instructions, to live out this conversation that you have with God. Now, from this same page here, we're going to zoom in to this right here. We know the four elements of Lectio Divina. Have you heard that before? Read, think, pray, and live. Each element has a purpose, but don't be surprised if they overlap and weave into each other. Remember, as you dive into this devotional, that Lectio Divina is about wholeness, solo, the one, whole practice, whole Bible, whole God. Now, here's what they're telling you. They're telling you that you can become one with God without the blood of Jesus Christ. That's what they're telling you. That is heresy. It is false doctrine. But that's what they're telling you. But this idea of four elements, it has everything to do with the elements of magic or elemental magic. We have earth, air, fire, and water. And earth, air, and fire, notice they're opposites. Earth and air are opposites. Fire and water are opposites. Notice they converge in what's called the cross point. Actually, there's five elements, earth, air, fire, water, and ether, or spirit. And I'll explain that here in a little bit. But earth, air, fire, and water, the four elements, are associated with winter, spring, autumn, and summer. Remember a few weeks ago, I taught you something that God had just shown me about the winter and the summer solstice. You remember that? The four quarters, the four seasons, and how they operate, how the sun rises and sets every year throughout the four seasons, and it makes a 46 degree rise and fall. You remember that? And how basically it's the rise of the sun god Tammuz, who is now dead, who is waiting resurrection. This is why they worship at the four, at the two solstices and the two equinoxes, because it represents the four elements. This is elemental magic that this book is teaching people to practice in a very subtle way, elemental magic. Why? To get people to bring up the rise of Tammuz through the 46 degrees, the 46 chromosomes, the body temple, the spark that's already inside of us, the kundalini, the snake that needs to rise up. All of these are tied together, people, and they link in with elemental magic. This idea that these four, you remember the avatar, the last airbender. These were all practitioners of this elemental magic that had the power over the wind, the air, power over the earth, power over fire, power over water. And it's indoctrinating everybody outside in the world, and probably a lot of church people are going, oh, this Avatar, Last Airbender, man, that's cool, man. I took my kid to watch it. Now, we're going to talk about it in Sunday school, how it relates to God. This is what they're doing. The four elements, you're going to like this. The four elements have everything to do with, remember, the 46, okay? The summer and the winter solstice, the sun rising up 46 degrees. So the four elements have everything to do, earth, air, fire, and water, with the four base pairs of our DNA. The bands that are how our DNA is banded together. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. It has everything to do with that, how we're banded together, okay? So the spirits are now telling the genetic scientists, play God, let's figure out how to redo this. Let's recombine the adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine. Let's practice elemental magic so that we can bring up the fifth element. And by the way, this graphic here, it's an online game that your kids can play. We're teaching everybody about elemental magic, to work the four elements and practice the witchcraft of the four elements so that we can rise up the fifth element. Manly